America's public road network spans more than 2.75 million miles of paved roads. This system connects every major population center and is vital to our economy, defense, and mobility. With fiscal constraints and increasing infrastructure needs, agencies are incorporating life cycle thinking into their planning.
It's just like owning a house. Everybody knows that every 18 to 20 years, you're going to replace the shingles on the house. Because once you let the water into the house, the cost of repairing the house goes up exponentially.
LongLife Pavements, traditionally called Perpetual Pavements, are pavement designs that provide agencies with an approach that reduces the life cycle costs of a pavement.
So there's a lot of emphasis on keeping the initial cost down. But if we look at the life cycle cost, LongLife Pavements are going to be cheaper in the long run. And then we can clearly see that if we build longer life pavements, we're going to get a lot more for our money.
LongLife flexible pavements are multi-layered pavement designs. They are designed and built from the bottom up, with the lower layer designed to resist bottom-up fatigue cracking, which limits damage to the easily repaired surface layer.
So at the bottom of the pavement's where you're going to see the most tensile strain. It's really like the pavement's being pulled apart every time a vehicle runs over it, kind of like a rubber band. And so you want something that's flexible to resist that pulling motion every time it's loaded. A little bit of polymer or a little bit of extra asphalt can be very beneficial in increasing that pavement flexibility, which will in turn increase its fatigue life.
I can fix the top easily, but if my base and my subbase are the source of my failure, now I have created a huge maintenance issue for the owner and the users in the future. So start with the proper structures, the proper foundation. When you build a house, you have solid footers.
The middle layer uses an asphalt mix designed to support anticipated traffic loads. And the top layer can be customized to local conditions, environment, and requirements.
Good mix designs, good production, good construction practices, make sure you have a multi-layer pavement system that is well built and well bonded between all those individual layers so that it can respond to passing loads monolithically. And then good maintenance, good preservation and maintenance practices on the surface.
LongLife pavement design takes into account external factors so agencies can forecast pavement performance and then specify an appropriate pavement structure for current and expected future needs.
Some of the critical keys are traffic loading, knowing what you're designing that for. The uniqueness about perpetual pavements is that we design it per layer to accommodate the overall loading of the pavement.
So the fatigue endurance limit is central to perpetual or long life pavement design. You have to have an estimate or somehow quantify the level at which cracking is not going to occur. Or if you design it in such a way that the stresses are low enough and the strains are low enough, you're not going to have cracks that initiate and propagate to the pavement surface.
LongLife Pavements optimize pavement structure through the right combination of thickness and materials. With bottom-up failure mitigated, agencies can focus on the relatively quick and simple maintenance of the surface riding layer. This design approach minimizes maintenance costs and reduces user delays for many highway agencies and owners across the U.S.
The Illinois Tollway, in designing its full-depth asphalt pavements, uses a long-life pavement design approach. We do look at all of the layers of the pavement system. So we've got a number of different full-depth asphalt pavements that I would consider long-life pavements. So we design with the materials and the thicknesses so that bottom-up distress doesn't happen in at least the 50-year design period that we're looking for.
Industry best practices and proven resources are available to help agencies better design long-life pavements and get longer service life from their roads. Some pavement design software applications developed through test track research include features like layered elastic analysis that enable users to design individual pavement layers, taking into account all appropriate variability.
and variability with how thick the layers are, variability in the material properties, variability of traffic. It puts all that together in a Monte Carlo simulation and estimates for you what the strain distribution is. That strain distribution can be compared back against a design distribution that we developed here at the test track to know whether your pavement passes or fails the long life pavement design criteria.
So as we start to look at mechanistic procedures, you can really see how your materials choices impact performance. So as states start to move towards that type of procedure, I think you're really going to see people to be more creative and open to innovation because they'll see the results of performance.
With long life pavement designs, asphalt roads can be built with a structure that lasts many decades with only periodic surface renewal and maintenance required, making it an ideal choice for drivers, engineers, and the traveling public.
All these have to come together in your long life. It's just not designing a thicker pavement. It's designing a smarter pavement with the right materials and not thinking thicker is always better, because there is a point that you have diminishing returns, that you're just spending money that you don't need to.
Building a long life pavement for the user is really critical because they want to have something that they're driving on that's economical, smooth, quiet, and long lasting. And building it correctly, spending that next incremental dollar, if you will, to doing it that way really does provide the user a long-term performing pavement.
For more information about asphalt best practices and emerging technologies, visit the Federal Highway Administration's website,